Hi, this is Jennifer Workmeister, Product Management for Adobe Analytics. I'm going to show you how to create custom date ranges for your mobile scorecard projects. Start with either a new scorecard or a saved project that you would like to edit. To edit the date ranges, click the date range selector at the top of your scorecard canvas. If you are starting with a new project, a list of preset example date ranges will populate here. If you are starting with a saved project, this will show the date ranges that you have already applied to the project. Please note that projects saved before the custom date range feature was launched came with a set of 26 preset date range combinations. All 26 will appear here, so you can remove unnecessary date ranges and provide your end user with a more streamlined experience. To remove a date range combination, click the X. And to edit a date range combination, click the pencil. Each date range combination has a primary date and a comparison date. To set the primary date range, click the drop-down menu to select familiar rolling presets, such as today, yesterday, or the last 30 days. You can also find the date components that you have access to, in my case, since app launch. I can also drag and drop from the left rail into the drop zone. Now let's pick a comparison date range. Because I picked last month, the UI is telling me that previous day doesn't make any sense. I can select convenient comparison date ranges from the drop-down menu. The drop-down menu for the comparison date will automatically adjust to supply date ranges that might make sense. In this case, I'm going to select the previous period. If the date you want doesn't exist already, you can create a new one by clicking on the calendar. This will take you to the date range builder, where you have several options for creating both fixed and rolling date ranges. Let's pretend I want a special date range for a sale last month. I will save it as a typical date range component, giving it a title. I can also add a description and tags. When you create a date range this way, you are creating a new date component that you can reuse and make available to others. Instead of comparing my February sale to the previous period, I'm going to compare it to 52 weeks earlier. Select OK to save my selection. To create an entirely new date range, you can drag and drop a date range component into the drop zone at the bottom of your list. Or if you want it to appear higher in your list, drag it over to where you want it to appear. Look for a blue line that tells you that you can drop it in that space. You can always reorganize the order of the date combinations later. Dragging it to either spot will open up a new date comparison for you to edit. Be sure to set your comparison date range to something that makes sense. You can also always create a new date range component by clicking on the calendar. Lastly, if you want to quickly add a standard set of daily, weekly, monthly, or yearly date range combinations, you can access all the preset combinations at once by clicking on the three dots in the drop zone at the bottom of your list. I'm going to select Add Standard Weekly Dates. I can add them all by selecting the top box, or I can select specific ones I think my end user will want to see. In this case, I'm going to select this week and the last full week. Lastly, as you can with other components in the mobile scorecard, I can retitle my date range components to a friendly name. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial on how to create custom date ranges for a mobile scorecard.